This short video lecture is on hydrograph recession analysis. A hydrograph is the graph of the changes in discharge as a function of time. The recession curve is the part of the hydrograph showing a gradual decrease in discharge, thus after the hydrograph has reached its peak. This figure shows a hydrograph, a graph of the changes in discharge along the vertical axis with time along the horizontal axis for a precipitation event, together with the number of hydrological terms used to describe a hydrograph. The discharge, or part of the discharge of a stream caused by processes delivering water rapidly to the stream, is called quickflow. For the discharge volume that stems from these rapid processes, we use the term quick flow volume. During periods with no precipitation, many streams, especially in humid areas, continue to carry water. The streams are fed by processes such as sustained groundwater flow and slow through flow through the soil matrix from an earlier precipitation event or events. The discharge, or part of the discharge of a stream caused by processes delivering water slowly to the stream, is called baseflow. For the related discharge volume, we use the term baseflow volume. The rising limb is part of the hydrograph with increasing discharge before the hydrograph has reached its peak, the peak being the maximum discharge during a precipitation event. The falling limb is part of the hydrograph with decreasing discharge after the hydrograph has reached its peak. The term recession curve is synonymous to the falling limb. The recession curve can be subdivided into a quick flow and base flow recession. Separation point is the point on the recession curve that separates the quick flow recession from the base flow recession. Inflection point is the separation point determined by assuming that the recession curve can be modeled as the discharge from linear reservoirs that represent quick flow and base flow. Finally, the time of concentration is the time required for surface water or other water contributing to the quick flow of a stream to flow from the farthest point in the watershed to the outlet. Streams that hold water throughout the year are called perennial, whereas a channel that only holds water during and immediately after a rain or snowmelt event is called ephemeral. An ephemeral stream thus has no base flow, only quick flow. This sheet shows a hydrograph of heavy rain on a wadi, a usually dry riverbed in a semi-arid climate, with the exception of periods during and shortly after heavy rainfall. A wadi thus is a type of ephemeral stream, and its discharge is made up solely of quick flow. For an ephemeral stream, the recession curve can conceptually be interpreted as outflow from a quick flow reservoir. The recession curve can mathematically be described as an exponential decrease starting at the hydrograph peak, as shown here. Qt is discharge at time t after the start of the recession in cubic meter per second. Q0 is discharge at the start of the recession in cubic meter per second, thus at the hydrograph peak, t is 0 seconds. E is the base of natural logarithms, 2.71, etc. Alpha is the recession constant in per day, and t is time in days. The equation can be rewritten for small constant time intervals delta t as shown here and here. What the latter equation boils down to is a characteristic of a negative exponential curve, e to the power minus alpha t, which is that after every time step delta t, a new value for qt plus delta t is obtained by multiplying the earlier value for qt by a constant factor e to the power minus alpha delta t that is smaller than 1. For a time step 2 delta t, you can use this constant factor squared. For a time step half a delta t, the square root of this constant factor, etc. The derivations are given here and here. The value of alpha determines the curvature of the decline of qt with time. Alpha has its unit per time. The larger alpha, the steeper the decline. You might find it easier to reason from the reciprocal of alpha, which then has a unit of time. If we name this constant c, then e to the power minus alpha t becomes e to the power minus t divided by c, and e to the power minus alpha delta t becomes e to the power minus delta t divided by c. Then, the larger the time constant c, the longer the time it takes, the slower the decline. Likewise, the smaller the recession constant alpha, the longer the time it takes, the slower the decline. Alpha ranges from 1,000th per day for deep groundwater to over 3 per day for overland flow. The equation can be rewritten in semi-logarithmic form as shown here. This equation plots as a straight line in a graph with ln qt on the vertical axis and t on the horizontal axis, and the value of alpha can simply be determined as the absolute value of the slope of this straight line. This sheet shows the hydrograph of a perennial stream, for instance, a stream in a humid climate setting. The discharge of the perennial stream is made up of both quick flow and baseflow. The recession curve of the hydrograph shown here can conceptually be interpreted as outflow from both a quick flow reservoir and a baseflow reservoir, with the larger outflow per unit of time from the quick flow reservoir. At the separation point, the quick flow reservoir has emptied, and from then on, there is only outflow from the baseflow reservoir. As the outflow from the quick flow reservoir is dominant, the first part of the recession curve after the hydrograph peak can simply be interpreted as outflow from the quick flow reservoir alone. The recession curve can therefore mathematically be described as first an exponential decreasing outflow from the quick flow reservoir, and then after the separation point, an exponentially decreasing outflow from the baseflow reservoir. For both parts of the recession, the just discussed equations can be used, be it with a different value of the recession constant alpha for the quick flow and baseflow reservoir. Note that the quick flow reservoir has been drawn with a larger opening at the bottom than the baseflow reservoir. The size of the opening and the friction are incorporated in the value of the recession constant alpha, alpha being largest for the quick flow reservoir with its fast depletion. The figure shows a baseflow separation line obtained using the constant slope inflection point method. The position of the inflection point is found as the point in time where the slope of the semi-logarithmic plot of ln qt versus t changes. The method has been extensively used by me when comparing hydrographs of brooks in small 1 to 2 square kilometer forested and grassland drainage basins in the Kuiper miles of Luxembourg. Because usually more than one inflection point is found on a recession curve, I use the inflection point with the lowest discharge as the selected inflection point to distinguish between quick flow and base flow. There are many methods for hydrograph separation into quick flow and base flow. All methods have in common that they are unavoidably arbitrary. Importantly, one should always stick to the method one sets off with when analyzing hydrographs, or else the comparison basis is lost. For all methods, the area under the hydrograph curve but above the baseflow separation line or curve gives the quickflow volume during the precipitation event in cubic meter, whereas the area under the separation line or curve gives the baseflow volume in cubic meter. There are many methods of hydrograph separation. This sheet shows three graphical methods. The constant discharge method A assumes that baseflow during a precipitation event is constant and equal to the discharge level at the start of the precipitation event. A large disadvantage of this method is that the discharge may not return to this starting level because of the start of a new precipitation event. The constant slope inflection point method B, used by me, assumes an immediate response in baseflow to precipitation and connects the start of the rising limb with the inflection point on the recession curve. The concave slope inflection point method C assumes a continued decrease in baseflow during the rising limb of the hydrograph and projects the declining antecedent baseflow recession prior to the precipitation event to directly under the hydrograph peak. The minimum obtained this way is then connected to the lowest inflection point on the recession curve.